Joining me now to talk more about this, Colonel Derek Harvey, director of the Global Initiative for Civil Society and Conflict at the University of South Florida. And Colonel, correct me if I'm wrong, but I do believe you had a role with CENTCOM during your days in the military, correct?
Yes, I was the director of the Afghanistan-Pakistan Center, doing the analytical work for the war in Afghanistan for General David Petraeus.
So you know CENTCOM, and your assessment about the ability of terrorists or pranksters or whomever to be able to hack into defense apparatus media accounts.
Well, I think going after social media accounts, whether it's Twitter, Tumblr, Pinterest, is a much easier task to achieve than it is going after the more secure classified networks or even some of their unclassified domains.
But the fact that they went after social media and some of those accounts, does it endanger, could it endanger our military personnel?
Well, I think the spokespeople saying that this is just cyber harassment are probably downplaying it too much. This indicates that the enemy is doing certain things. And one, they're getting a great deal of publicity. They are creating real concerns amongst those that work at CENTCOM and other military and government facilities. And in response to this, even beforehand, the CENTCOM command and others have told military members and employees to downplay their use of social media, not identify themselves as being part of the military, the government, or intelligence, and to be much more careful about identifying themselves by stickers and things on their cars, too. Let's keep in mind, I think, one thing. These organizations have been operating very effectively in developing target sets in places like France, Germany, in the Middle East, through social media, getting names and places of security people, leaders in Jewish communities and other communities, so that they can then disseminate that information and hope a lone wolf or somebody else targets those people or those businesses.
About 2.5 minutes remaining in this segment. The pronouncement from the White House, at least from Presidential Press Secretary Josh Earnest, is as follows. Quoting now, there's a pretty significant difference between a large data breach and the hacking of a Twitter account. Do you share that? You were saying earlier you thought the government response was downplaying this. In your mind, just how dangerous was what we saw with this this hack into social media?
I don't think it's a dangerous hack, but I think it indicates a couple of things here. We are increasingly vulnerable, particularly in the United States, because of the way we depend upon the internet, and it's going to expand exponentially over the next decade as more and more systems, home security, your networks at home, et cetera, are increasingly dependent upon the internet. So we're going to be increasingly vulnerable. But two, social media can provide a great deal of information for these people to use against us. Thirdly, it is highlighted for them, and it's been a publicity bonanza, this hack and advertising the cyber caliphate in the way that they did. But we don't know the attribution. It might not have been ISIS, it may have been supporters or anonymous. And they did it on the same day that the president was announcing his cybersecurity initiative.
Mindful of that, 1 minute remains, Colonel Derek Harvey, and let's go to the rationale for social media accounts being used by the military. Why do we have them? Why does our military have those social media accounts?
Well, there's an element of public information and information sharing in order to communicate to our domestic public and others about what we're doing, why we're doing it, in a way to shape and influence debate, in my view.
Fair enough. We'll have to leave it there. Colonel Derek Harvey, retired from CENTCOM, now the director of the Global Initiative for Civil Society and Conflict at the University of South Florida. Colonel, as always, you have our thanks. And I would imagine we're going to be calling on the Colonel much more often in the days ahead, given the stories that we have seen thus far in this new year. Hey, just one note to you if you're watching us on Dish Network. Of course, you can watch us there 24/7 on channel 223. Right now, you're also able to watch us on channel 206 on Dish, and of course on DirecTV, always.